Hi, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. If you want to report on the loading time of your pages in GA4, Google Analytics 4, you're in the right place. I'm going to show you how you can measure and report on page load time in GA4. If you've been looking for page load time metrics in GA4, you might be wondering if you're missing something. Well, you're not alone. Currently, there are no built-in page load time metrics. However, with the help of Google Tag Manager, I'll walk you through the exact steps to set this up so you can see page load time in your reports. We're going to use Google Tag Manager to track the time it takes for each page to load on our website in real time. We'll send this to GA4 using a custom event. Then we'll use a custom metric and a calculated metric to include page load time in our reports. Finally, we'll create an exploration report to analyze the loading time of our pages. Okay, let's get started. Let's head to Google Tag Manager. I've already logged into the GTM container that's installed on my website. If you're already using GTM, I'm guessing you've already implemented GA4. But let's quickly confirm this by navigating to Tags. We can see there's a Google tag that's sending data to GA4. You'll need this in your container too. If you don't see this and you're just getting started, then I recommend watching my tutorial series covering GTM and checking out my courses. I've included links in the description below this video. And if you already have a Google tag sending data to GA4, you're ready to continue to the next step. So let's navigate to variables. Now let's create a new user-defined variable. And let's name the variable page load time. Let's select a variable configuration and choose custom JavaScript as the variable type. Now let's head to my blog. Here we can see the custom JavaScript we will use to calculate the loading time of our pages. I've included a link to this in the description below this video. Okay, let's copy the code. This uses the Performance Navigation Timing API and calculates the amount of time in milliseconds between load event end and start time, which gives us the page load time. We then take the number of milliseconds and convert it to seconds. If you prefer to report on milliseconds instead of seconds, you can adjust the JavaScript. This provides more granular reporting in Google Analytics. I've included a version of the script for milliseconds in my blog post. Okay, now let's head back to Google Tag Manager and paste the JavaScript code. Now let's select Format Value, enable the option Convert Undefined To, and let's enter 0 as the value. This means that if the Navigation Timing API fails, the variable will return a value of 0. Now let's save the variable. The next step is to create a trigger to fire a tag for our page load event. So let's navigate to Triggers. Let's click New to create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger page load time greater than 0. Let's select Trigger Configuration and choose Page View Window Loaded as the trigger type. Now let's select some window loaded events. And using the drop-down, let's select our page load time variable. Now let's select greater than for the condition and enter 0. We're adding this condition to make sure the tag only fires when a page load time has actually been recorded. If the value is zero or missing, then it likely means the browser didn't provide a valid timing value, and we don't want to send incomplete data to Google Analytics. By checking that the value is greater than zero, we help ensure that we collect accurate data. Now let's save the trigger. The next step is to create a GA4 event tag to send the loading time of our pages to Google Analytics. Let's navigate to Tags. And let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Page Load Time. And let's select Tag Configuration. Let's select Google Analytics, and let's choose GA4 event as the tag type. Now we need to select our GA4 measurement ID. I've already created a variable, so I'm going to select this. Again, if you're just getting started, then I've included extra resources for you in the description below this video. Okay, now let's name our event page_load_time. Now we need to select event parameters. And let's add a row. Let's name the parameter loading_time_sec. And for the value, let's select our page load time variable. Now we need to select triggering. And let's choose the page load time greater than zero trigger we just created. Now let's save the tag. And let's click Preview. Enter our URL. And click Connect. Our website loads and it's connected to Tag Assistant. Now let's select the Tag Assistant tab. And let's select the window loaded event on the left. We can see our page load time tag has been fired. Let's select the tag. And let's ensure that values is selected on the top right corner. This lets us see the value being sent to Google Analytics. So here we can see the loading time for this page. Once you're happy everything is working correctly, it's time to head back to GTM. And let's click Submit to publish our changes. Let's name our version. And click Publish. The loading time of our pages will now be sent to Google Analytics. Next, we need to register our loading time parameter in GA4 as a custom metric. To do this, let's head to Google Analytics. Let's navigate to Admin. Select Data Display on the left. Then Custom Definitions. And let's select the Custom Metrics tab. And click Create Custom Metric. Let's name the metric page load time. Enter loading_time_sec as the event parameter. And select seconds as the unit of measurement. Now let's save our custom metric. Moving forward, you will be able to use the metric in your reports. However, our custom metric will report the total loading time of each page on our website, not the average loading time. So let's create a calculated metric. To do this, let's select the Calculated Metrics tab and click Create Calculated Metric. Let's name our calculated metric Average Page Load Time. And for the formula, let's enter Page Load Time / Event Count. And for the unit of measurement, let's ensure standard is selected. This will give us the average page load time for each event on our website. Now let's save our calculated metric. Now that we're tracking page load time, the next step is to report on the performance of our pages. You can do this by creating a custom exploration report or using Looker Studio. Let's create an exploration report. To create an exploration report that includes our page load time metrics, let's navigate to Explore. And let's click blank to create a new report. Let's name the report. And let's click the plus sign next to Dimensions. I'm going to search for Page. And I'm going to enable the Page Path and Screen Class Dimension. But you can use any of the page-based dimensions in your report. And I'm also going to search for and enable Event Name. Now let's click Confirm. And let's click the plus sign next to Metrics. And let's search for and enable Event Count. Now let's search for Page Load Time. And let's enable both of our metrics. Now let's click Confirm. And let's add the Page Path Dimension and our metrics to the report by double-clicking them. We can now see our pages along with the number of events, average loading time, and total loading time. But this will include events other than our page load time event, so we need to add a filter to our report. Let's scroll down the second column. And add a filter. Let's select event name, then exactly matches, and choose our page load time event. We can now see the average page load time and total page load time for the pages on our website. Remember that you will only be reporting on these metrics from the time you publish your GTM container and people visit your website, so you will need to check back after a day to see data in your exploration report. Now that you're tracking page load time in GA4, you can report on the performance of your content. I recommend using the report we created to identify pages with lots of views that are also slower to load. You can then optimize those pages. To get a pre-configured GTM container for tracking page load time, I've included a link in the description below this video. If you would like to explore additional options for reporting on page load time, such as editing standard reports or creating a Looker Studio report, please let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. And to learn even more about GA4 and GTM, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel and check out my courses. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.